If you would like to support this channel, there are many ways. Become a patron and gain benefits from early access to a direct line to myself at any time, or use the tipping link in the description. This will help the channel to grow and help to fund the trip to Reykjavik for the EVE FanFest this April, to get any and all information to you as quickly as possible. Thank you all for your support, and remember to like and subscribe if you haven't already. The most mysterious and elusive of all the peoples of New Eden, the Jove number only a fraction of any of their neighbours, but their technological superiority makes them powerful beyond all proportion. The highest known governmental body is the Jovian Directorate, within the Jove Empire, though this has never been confirmed or denied by the Jove. The structure and purpose of the Jovian Directorate remains uncertain. The Jove Navy is a powerful group, but remains small due to the Jovian disease. They rely on information and their advanced weaponry to destroy their opponents. Although definitely human, the Jovians often seem to the other races as though they are not, the reason being that they embrace genetic engineering as the way to solve any and all the problems which plague the human race. Over the thousands of years since, the Jovians have experimented with every kind of genetic modification their technology allowed. As their powers grew, they began to believe they were capable of anything, and this led them into increasingly more bizarre mutations of their bodies and minds, a policy rigorously backed up by a strict government control. Jovians have a very strange appearance. They are mainly between 4 and 6 feet tall, and their skin is a greyish yellow, their veins clearly visible. They have also lost all hair on their bodies, their features are very softened, and their pupils are much larger than those of most humans, to the point that their sclerae are nearly impossible to see. Female Jove have pupils that are a little smaller, making their sclerae visible, if barely. The Drifters have many implants all over their bodies. Their sclerae are black, and their pupils are brownish yellow. The Jovians crave knowledge, any knowledge at all. Their superior technology has enabled them to infiltrate the other races with bugging devices and sensors, giving them unrivaled access to information, which they use to maintain their strong position among the races. The Jovians sell a lot of their advanced technology equipment to the other races, and it is this, more than anything else, which keeps the others at bay. The Jovian language is a very strange tongue. Speech consists entirely of vowels, fluctuates rapidly in frequency. Jovian society is mysterious and difficult to comprehend. For this, and other reasons, it remains very much closed to the other races, and few foreigners reside within the Jove Empire. Years of genetic engineering formed the Jovian disease, a deadly disease that only afflicts the Jove, which has caused millions of Jove to die as a result of interfering with their basic instincts, curbing their aggression and sexual instincts, and cultivating strange new ones from the Shrouded days. The Jove tried to fix the problem, only to discover their DNA was destroyed beyond repair. The Jove tried many things to fight against the disease, but found that their advanced technology was ineffective against it. Finally, they created the three Jovian motherships, and placed the majority of their population into cryostasis, leaving their home territories in the process. Anyone who showed symptoms of the disease was left behind to perish. However, the relocation failed. The Jovian disease continued to afflict the Jove. Despite this, the Jove escaped the chaos that followed the closure of EVE remarkably well. Within the space of only a few centuries, they had recovered, and were once again running an advanced society. They settled in a number of systems and founded an empire lasting for 9 millennia. Despite the new founding, they have not recovered the splendor of their first empire, as the disease within them keeps them from reproducing, thus preventing them from increasing their numbers sufficiently for their current empire to flourish. As expected, one of the Jove primary goals is to find a cure to the Jovian disease. The first Jovian empire dates as far back as the collapse of the EVE Gate. Even though the collapse of the EVE Gate had a negative effect on the Jovian society, the effect was only minor, and the Jove quickly recovered back to a state of being an advanced society within a few centuries. This marked the birth of the first Jovian Empire, which would last for 9 millennia. The eventual downfall of this empire was brought about by the Jovian Elders, though the exact details are shrouded in mystery, though few speculate that the likely contributor to the downfall of the first Jovian Empire could be the Jovian disease, which is said to have appeared as the result of the Shrouded days. The Jovian Elders maintained a strict governmental control over genetic alterations, however they eventually lost control for a few generations. In the second Jovian Empire, the Jovians were reunited by Mekko Bor, and the second Jovian Empire was formed under his leadership, lasting approximately 2,500 years. In a desperate attempt to finally rid themselves of the Jovian disease after failing to find a cure, the Jovians decided to abandon their homeworlds in Curse in three massive motherships and settled the regions of J7H7-TAC-F and A821-TAC-A, where the Third Empire resides to this day. In the Third Jovian Empire, since the Shrouded days, they have been trying to put the pieces together again, but their DNA structure has in many ways been damaged beyond more repair. The current of the Jovian Empires has prevailed for just over 500 years. Despite the relocation of homeworlds, the Jovian disease is still prevalent among the Jovian society, continuing their steady decline. Since introducing Capsuleer technology to the Ishikone Corporation, defeating the Amar Empire at the Battle of Vakaatioth, participating in the establishing of Concord, and wiping out the original Sanctus nation alongside the other four empires, the Jove have become more reclusive on the interplanetary political scene with very little public communication with the other empires. With a few exceptions like Venial and the Society of Conscious Thought, the Jove have kept little contact with the other empires since the Capsuleer technology was released to the public. Later, a massive supernova known as the Caroline Star disabled the entire Jovian gate network, and it has remained disabled ever since. The current status of the Jove in their territory, whether they're still alive or not, remains unknown. It is known that a short time before the supernova occurred, the Jove had successfully developed the technology to open their own wormholes without jump gates, eliminating the need for them. The latest contact with the Jove was when the Directorate transferred the ownership of Genolution, Impro, and Xsense, the Society of Conscious Thought. The rest of the Jovian story is for us, the Capsuleers, to find out. Fly safe.